Hey there guys, so this is going to be my first ever movie review. I'm going to be reviewing a movie which came out within the past week, which I seen at the cinema recently. It was called American Assassin. Now, when I saw the trailer for this movie, initially I was excited. Now, when the movie came out, I saw it a few days after its release, and I had read a couple of reviews prior to seeing the movie, and a lot of the reviews I saw were very negative. Apparently the movie was very bland, you know, quite boring, a bit of a wasted opportunity. But I looked at the cast for this movie, and I looked at the trailers, you know, I kind of bought the hype a little bit. And honestly, when I saw who was going to be in the cast, this movie actually did have me quite excited. And I thought it was going to be one of those movies that the critics basically panned without really giving it a chance. That's what I thought going into this movie. I actually did think that we were going to get a good movie, because when I saw the cast, when I saw they had Michael Keaton, who's a fantastic actor, Scott Adkins too, who in my opinion is one of the most underrated, certainly one of the most underrated martial arts actors in the world. You know, probably my favourite martial arts actor of all time. He's an actor from the UK who is best known for his portrayal of Yuri Boyka in the Undisputed movies, which were some of my favourite martial arts movies ever. You really need to check those movies out. I would really recommend those movies. It also had Taylor Kitsch, who portrayed the villain. All of those guys are really good actors. Dylan O'Brien, who played the lead role, I didn't really know much about him, but from what I saw from the trailers, he seemed competent enough. So I thought that with the cast that this movie had, I thought that if nothing else, at least we were going to get a decent action flick, you know, a good popcorn movie. Unfortunately, it was a completely wasted opportunity, and the critics were absolutely right. I mean, I mentioned Scott Adkins earlier. Complete wasted opportunity. They basically, spoiler alert, by the way, they basically killed Scott Adkins off 20 minutes into the movie, maybe not even that. It was ridiculous. I mean, when you have an actor who's so talented at stunts and martial arts and choreography with fight scenes, to kill him off like that after giving him basically nothing to do. I mean, the guy has like two or three lines of dialogue with really not much to say, no character development at all. He has basically a sparring session in the movie, which is, I don't even class that a fight scene, okay, because the guys were just training and the stunts weren't even that well done, to be honest. I mean, when you know, Scott Adkins is very talented, but he needs to be given something, you know, he needs to be given some sort of direction. You know, if you're going to use a martial artist like Scott Adkins, then use him, you know, don't just put him in the movie and then kill him off so quickly. Now, without a doubt, the best thing about the movie was Michael Keaton. Michael Keaton, you know, I'm quite big on him at the moment, particularly after his recent portrayal as the villain in the new Spider-Man movie. He played the Vulture. Very, very talented actor. Obviously, he was Batman for a couple of movies. Like I said, he stole the show. He was what saved this movie from being absolutely dreadful. I would say that every single scene in this movie with Michael Keaton was certainly entertaining. I mean, he really plays this real rough, tough, ruthless, really, really brutal individual who just, you know, he has no emotions whatsoever. I mean, the guy's methodical. He's, you know, he's training these guys to be elite assassins that are trained to take out terrorists. And he's basically fucking with these guys' minds. You know, there's a scene in the movie where he shows, I don't want to give away too much of the plot, but basically he shows a video recording of something that happened, which is detrimental in the main character's life, involving a love interest of his. And yeah, basically he does this to really upset the guy and to provoke a response from him. And the reason why he's doing it is because he's trying to teach the guy not to allow the mission to become personal. And I did like that. I like that element to this movie, how he was really, really trying to desensitize these assassins. I really like that, and I really wish that they had done more with it. And obviously, this ties into the main villain of the movie too, because him and Michael Keaton's character have history there. Obviously, Michael Keaton's character was connected with him through this assassin training. Now, again, I don't really want to give away too much of the plot. I don't want to reveal any spoilers, but I really thought that they should have expanded on that more. I mean, Taylor Kitsch does as the villain here. He does a very good job, but again, similar to Scott Adkins, he just wasn't really given much. You know, he didn't really get much screen time, and I felt a lot of the movie was, you know, just a little bit bland. You know, to me, there just wasn't enough action, and the action that was there was mostly, you know, it felt rushed to me, and I just felt that the movie could have, you know, it could have been a bit more deep. Obviously, when you've got actors like this, you know, such a talented cast, there could have been a lot more action. But overall, it wasn't a terrible movie. I just felt that it was a complete wasted opportunity. You know, the plot, gotta be honest, I didn't really feel the plot. I felt it was pretty cliche. Again, I don't want to give too much away, but it was I found it to be a very cliche plot. You know, there was a lot of, you know, a bomb's going to go off. You know, they've captured plutonium and they're going to set off a bomb and whatnot, and it's going to start a war. I mean, it's your typical shit you've seen in 100 action movies. And yeah, I just felt complete wasted opportunity. I wouldn't recommend this movie, to be honest. And this is some, you know, you're hearing this from someone who went into this movie with an open mind, who actually didn't go in just ready to bash the movie, like I think a lot of people did. I actually did give the movie a chance, and to me, the movie just was a complete wasted opportunity. You know, I love a good action movie as much as the next man, but this movie just didn't do it for me. So, you know, I don't really have like a grading system. Like I said, I've never reviewed a movie like this before. So, but say if I was to give this movie like a score out of 10, I'd probably give it a 4 out of 10, something like that. So yeah, below average. It just wasn't that good a movie. It was pretty boring. I understand why the critics were harsh on it. Well, at least the critics that I read anyway. It was just a boring movie. It was just a wasted opportunity. And I really thought that from the trailer that I saw and from the cast that was in this movie, I really think that they could have done so much more with it. So anyway, let me know what you guys thought of the movie. I'm not really that into doing movie reviews. I just thought I'd have a go at it here. You know, I mainly talk about boxing on my channel, but, you know, let me know if you'd like to see me review other movies. I might do that sometime. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think anyway, and thanks for watching.